in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 7. For God has not called us unto uncleanness. You see, now we are all called by God. God has not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. Holiness is not, there's no two ways about it. You must be holy. Say the Lord that it's not negotiable. Say the Lord have not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. The Lord wants to use you to showcase his glory to the people. The Lord wants to be an epitome of who he is. He wants to use you to tell the world he is a holy God. He has given birth to a holy daughter, which is you. Remember, he told us in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. He said, but you are a choosing generation. You and I are choosing generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a holy people, a holy woman. That's why God never called you in sin. He called you out of sin. Once he called you out of sin, he beautify you and make you a holy person. And that holiness must remain in you. But you are a choosing generation. He chose you out of many. There are billions of people out there. They are rigmaroling. They are in far country of sin. But he singled you out. You were singled out of many. Many people that did the same thing you did when you were in the world, most of them are still there now. But today, you are in the holy ground of the Lord, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar person. And the Lord wants you to manifest your peculiarity. You are peculiar. You are a peculiar vessel in the hands of God. So you must go out there and manifest your peculiarity. You are a daughter of the greatest royal highness. He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So therefore, you must maintain that standard. The Lord has a standard. What is that standard? Holiness. He will not compromise his holiness for anything. He can change the world, but he will not change his holiness. He remains holy. So he also wants you and I to go there and show the people that he is a holy God that give birth to a holy daughter and a holy son like you. That you should show forth his praise, a peculiar people, that you should show forth his praise of him who has called you out of darkness. Mm-hmm. Out of darkness.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
His marvelous light.
Amen.
You must manifest that light. You have no other alternative that will manifest light.
Amen.
You are a luminous. You are a luminous person. You are a light manifestor. So, go out there and showcase who you are. Let all your doings, your lifestyle, showcase who you are. You are a child of God. You are a light in this earth. The whole earth is dark. You are the only reason why there's still light on earth now. You better know this. The earth is darkened. You are the reason why there's still light on earth here. It told us in Hebrews 12, 14, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which nobody can see the Lord. Your light will not go off in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Therefore, what do we do? He said, we must be holy unto him. Leviticus 20, 26. You shall be holy unto me, for I, the Lord, I am holy, and I have saved you. And I have saved you from other people, that you should be mine. He put you out from among prostitutes. He put you out of among drug barons. He put you out of among those people who go to party every Saturday. He singled you out that you might be his. That I might be his. I am not the only person right here. It's not only you is there, but he picked you out because he knows he can be proud of you. You are a vessel unto honor. You must not dishonor yourself. You must not let down yourself. Whenever we sin against God, we are letting down ourselves, not even God. We are letting down ourselves. And whatever don't make us to let ourselves today, the Lord has taken them away from us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold. I'm reading 2 Timothy chapter 2 from verse 20 to 22. But in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. Your own is the first one. The Lord have called you unto honor. He wants to honor you. That's why he's humiliating the devil all the time because of you. To honor you. Some to honor, some to dishonor. Verse 21. If a man therefore, the Lord will not force you to honor you. You are the one to make yourself ready. Say, Lord, I am a ready vessel to be honored. Say,
yes.
If a man therefore poured himself from this thing, you know what you are doing that you should pour yourself from. You know those little things, saying that the devil is accusing you of. Whenever the Lord wants to honor you, it shows the Lord that side of you. This brother is a liar, you cannot honor him. This sister is this, you cannot honor him. She's a barbiter, she's this, she's a revealer, you know what you are doing that you must purge yourself from. And the Lord, remember, we have just 2 days. 2 days to go. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
2 days to go. In these 2 days, you must be honored in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
No matter what that bugger tried to do, challenging himself, why would you do that? Get off me, because the Lord is with me. If any man therefore purge himself from these things, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified and meant for the master's use. The Lord want to make use of you. The Lord
Amen.
Will bless you. The Lord
Amen.
Will use you. The Lord, the Lord will tell Amen. The world that is the Almighty. He wants to use you to do that. Allow him. Sister, allow him. He will not force you, but he wants to do it. That's why he told us in Revelation 2:20. Say, I stand at the door. The Lord is at your door to honor you. Oh God. The Lord is with that honor, that crown of glory to honor you. Don't allow him to take him back, to take it back again. I should purge myself. Let every one of us purge ourselves so that, Revelation 3:20 rather, 3:20. The Lord is standing by our door to honor us. He said, my daughter, is just 2 days to go in the assignment I gave to you. You are doing it. You have not missed any day. But that thing in you is still hindering you. Get angry unnecessarily. You keep malice unnecessarily. You are too proud. That proudness must go. You're a gossiper. Stop it. I want to showcase you now. Your time to be glorified has come. Jesus can say, my Father, glorify thou me, for I have glorified you.
Oh, yes.
You have glorified him by honoring him, by listening to his voice. When people are sleeping, you are on the mountain praying. The Lord wants to baptize you with honor. Allow him. We should allow him. He wants to use us to showcase to the devil that he is the Almighty. They sanctify for the master's use and prepare unto every good work. Every good work. In the morning, he will make use of you. In the afternoon, he will remember you. Say, yes, that sister is wonderful. In the night, he will still use you. Not maybe money and in the night he abandoned you. No, you are not an abandoned project. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You are meant to be used all the time by the Lord. Not if the money come to you, you are clean before 11 o'clock, you have gone back. No, you must be clean at all times. So what do you do? Verse 22. Flee all useful lusts. Or follow righteousness. 8. Charity, peace with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. The Lord is doing wonderful things now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord will increase us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Then in 2 Peter chapter 1 from verse 3, say, according as his divine power has given unto us all things, say all things.
All things.
Lots of things. All things that will make you to be a blessing. All things that will make you to be prepared for rapture. All things pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that called us. Who told you you don't have calling? You have a calling.
People
right from your mothers who called you. He said, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I know you, I sanctified thee, and I sent you forth. Jeremiah 1, verse 5 to 10. I've sent you to pull down, to build, to uproot, to bless, to curse. The power is in you. Say to yourself, I am called by God.
I am called by God.
You don't need any man to lay hands on you and say, I profess for you. No, it is in there. It is an imbued thing. We all, as a child of God, we are called of God. According as he has divine power, giving unto us all things pertaining to life. I read first from verse 3. Through the knowledge, I come again. According as his divine power has given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that called us to glory and virtue. Oh God.
Yes.
You must manifest that glory. It's a natural phenomenon. You don't need it. It is there for you. May the God of all grace, who have called us into his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10, into his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that you have suffered the while. Before these 40 days, you'll be suffering. The end has come now. You have called eternal glory. For you to be glorified, the Lord will baptize you with glory in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Glory and virtue. Verse 4. Whereby I give you unto us exceeding great and precious promises. What else do you want again? What else do we want again? That by this you might be partaker of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in this world through lust. I am an escapee. You have escaped the corruption of this world. We are no more corrupted again.
Amen.
We were corrupted, but the Lord came and took us out of that miry clay. Today, you are a partaker of God's divine nature. Nature that cannot be destroyed. Nature that cannot be afflicted. The body of Christ is not your body. the blood of Christ flow in your vein. So that whoever is planning evil against you is wasting time. The time to plan evil against you, they waste it. It's a wasted effort. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Even though you don't believe, I don't even believe it is so. It is natural. As far as you are a child of God, whoever that plan evil against you, sister gift, they are only wasting time. The time that to plan evil against you is a time wasted.
Yes.
Praise Master Jesus.
Verse
5.
Yeah.
Beside this, give it all diligence. Add to your faith virtue, and to your faith knowledge. 6. And to your knowledge temperance. These are the prerequisites to attain to that everlasting glory. And to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness. These are things we must pray for. Father, let all these things be in me. Verse 7. And to godliness, brotherly kindness. And to brotherly kindness, charity. For all these things, for if it's not by force, you are the one to work for them, Sister Dupe. If these things be in you and abound, not they are there in the morning before 12 o'clock, they fly away. In the next again, you come to the mountain, it put upon you again. Before no, if it's in you and abound, that's what God is looking for. People who are steadfast, people who can stay put in holiness. It will come to you today, you are still there. Tomorrow, you are still there. Persistency. It's great to persist. Receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren. You shall neither be barren, nor unfruitful in the knowledge of God, of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh all these things, he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and have forgotten that he was purged from his old sin. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Verse 10. Say, wherefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, wherefore the call of God, wherefore the royal priesthood of Jesus Christ, wherefore the pride of Jesus, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling. Who said you are not called is a lie. Because you don't know who you are. A damn man have calling, and me, I don't have calling. You are causing yourself. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. The power is your hands. You are to make it sure. As they told us in 2 Timothy 2, verse 15, study to make yourself approved unto God. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly divided the word of truth. You are the one to say, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. If you value your salvation, you will do everything necessary to keep it. You value the crown that you are about to receive. You will do everything necessarily to make sure you keep yourself pure. Wherefore, you rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never fall. You will never fall. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
None of us shall fall in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
What the Lord require of us to do, for you and I not to fall. The grace to do it, we receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
I'll close it for time. 2 Corinthians 7 verse 1. See, having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us clean ourselves. Now that we know that God will honor us, Now that we know that God is proud of us. Now that we know that God wants us to go out there, His eyes is watching us to see how we will behave ourselves. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, dearly co-pilgrims on earth, dearly beloved children of the Most High, let us clean ourselves from all filthiness, of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Let the fear of the Lord guide you. As you enter that supermarket, let the fear of the Lord be your guide.
Oh, yes.
Telling you, test that thing. And you know you will not buy it. Don't test what you will not buy. Let the fear of the Lord be your best friend. You will never make mistake. You will never fall. When you make the fear of God your best friend, not even your husband. Your husband should be secondary. The fear of God should be number one. The fear of God should be the first thing in your life. Without the fear of the Lord, you will faint on this race. The devil will trick you. The devil will blast you out. Let the fear of God guide you. Perfecting holiness in the fear of God. And I believe on that day, we all shall wear our crown in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's why I say, I am running my race. I will finish my race. I will wear my crown when I get to heaven. No matter what the devil do, no matter what the people do, I will wear
my crown
when
I get to heaven.
Sister, you are running
a race.
Hey. You will finish your race.
In Jesus' name.
You will get the crown. Apostle Abraham, you are running a race. You will finish your race.
In Jesus' name.
I know.
You will get your crown.
Apostle Peace, you are running a race.
Yes, you are running a race.
I know by the grace of God, you will finish your race.
Amen.
I know you will. Everybody sing,
we are running our crown.
We will get our crown.
By the grace of God, we are crowned.
Hallelujah. The Lord is a wise God. He doesn't crown anybody on earth here. If not, all these bishops would have rushed the crown and put it on their head and say, I'll tell us to go away. I've gone there, go to the warehouse of the crown and bust it with that brother and pick the crown. But everyone must finish it on earth here and go and wear it up there. I believe, by the grace and mercy of God, everyone on this mountain, we all will finish well.
Amen.
The last day in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anything that is waging war against us 10 years to come, 20 years to come, say, okay, let them suffer now. When they are 10 years, I will make them fall. That thing is dead now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Because I know you have blessed us this money.
Oh, yes.
As we go out there, we will showcase you.
Yes,
amen.
The glory will radiate in us.
Amen.
Then we see us and say, yes, these are the children of the Most High.
Amen.
Even before we say we are Christians, our lifestyle will showcase the God in us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The things that will be manifesting, the fire they will be seeing, they will say, yes, only Christ's children can have this fire.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. I receive it in Jesus' name.
We will never disgrace our Father again in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Brethren, if you are out there, you are not born again, you are missing. You better come and enjoy what Sister Dupe is enjoying. Come and enjoy what the apostles are enjoying. You may have car, have houses, but you are living a wasted life. What shall it profit you to gain those things and lose your soul? Come and preserve this thing, those things in the presence of God.
Oh, yes.
Come with your riches. The Lord will preserve them for you.
That's
and preserve your soul.
Oh, yes.
You see that blessing now, my people, the people of God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord release riches upon you. He will preserve the riches for you, and your soul will be preserved also in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say after me, if you want to join us in this joyful boat, ship, aircraft that we are on now.
It's a lovely one.
Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. My heart is pleading that I have not been a part of this. I have been a sinner, a wretched one at that. I've been in a very far continent of sin. But today, I've decided to come back home.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Daddy, have mercy on me. Forgive me all my sin. I'm sorry for all that I've caused you. Take my name away from the book of death, Daddy. And write it again in the book of life.
Amen.
I accept you, Lord, as my Lord and personal Savior.
Amen.
All things have passed away today.
Amen.
And all things have become new.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for sending your word my way this morning.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you for saving my soul from the pit of hell.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus Christ's name, we have declared.
Amen.
Brother, sister, if you have declared this declaration, I and Sister Julia Amaka rejoice with you.
Heaven
rejoice with you.
Amen.
Please to run this race to the end, receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So guys, it might be rough, but the grace to stay put, receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you are blessed by this word, give a clap of it to our Lord Jesus Christ.